Ms. Barrow is a clinical associate professor of dental hygiene at New York University.
Can I interrupt you?
Shoot.
I am no longer at New York University.
Oh.
I am at the University of Melbourne in Australia.
Oh!
Yes.
Well, a longer commute.
So I wanted to tell you that. So that's changed. I'm sorry.
Wow, much longer
so
commute.
Should I introduce myself then? Yes, why don't you do that?
I'll turn the mic right on over.
Okay.
Give just a moment and they'll turn on that
Thank
mic.
You.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, according to my previous life, I was at New York University for 15 years, teaching in the dental hygiene program and coordinator of the baccalaureate program for dental hygiene. But last year, I got an invitation from the University of Melbourne to help them with their dental hygiene curriculum because it's a new profession in Australia. So I'm on an adventure of a lifetime. I'm going to be there until 2011, so New York University was not going to hold my position, so I had to resign after 15 years. So it's fine. It's fine. I just want to enjoy my experience. So I arrived yesterday, and I'm leaving tomorrow. Yes. So that's why you didn't see me today. I'm just a wee bit jet lagged. So this is a very important topic that I'm going to discuss with you today. I'm really sorry that some of you are pressed for time because of the problem with the timing of the program. But let's start. I want to start with a case report. I didn't just want to start like right into a lecture. So I thought it would be interesting for us as dental hygienists and probably some of the periodontists and general dentists here that this is the type of patient that we see in our practice. So the patient comes in, the patient has a chief complaint. And often, patients don't report this complaint to the dentist. They think it's a very trivial thing, so they share it more with the dental hygienist. They see us more often for their periodic visits and for their maintenance, and when we scale and root plane, that's when they tell us. Ooh. So, this is important. So I just want you to think about this patient, this scenario, and we're gonna discuss it at the end. So it's a young lady, she's 24 years old, she's a college student. She doesn't have any health coverage, and we know that that's an issue in the United States. There are lots of us and lots of our patients that don't have health coverage. So she's a fanatic for her oral health and for her general health. So she experiences a sharp, dull pain when she drinks cold beverages. On clinical examination of this patient, periodontal pocketing range from 3 to 5 millimeters. There's no bleeding upon probing. There's attrition present, and you can see that. There's abrasion, and there's also recession. And these are characteristics of what you would see with a patient who reports with sensitivity, dentinal hypersensitivity. So these are the classic signs. The radiographic interpretation, no significant findings. Medical history, she's a healthy person. But her oral hygiene and her diet, well, she has a very acidic diet. She eats at least four to six pieces of fruit per day between her classes because she's rushing around and she has a part-time job. She has a half a grapefruit in the morning. And because she's a fanatic about her oral health, she brushes every time she eats. And that's during the day also. Many nights when she's studying, she falls asleep. So she doesn't brush her teeth at night. So this is might be a very extreme, severe case, but I'm sure you've seen patients with one or two of these signs and symptoms in your practices. So let's talk about this condition, dental hypersensitivity. It is characterized by short, sharp pain arising from exposed dentin in response to stimuli, typically thermal, evaporative, tactile, osmotic, or chemical, and which cannot be ascribed to any other form of dental defect or pathology. So this is what our patients suffer with, these symptoms. There are other terms that this condition has also been called, such as dentin hypersensitivity, tooth sensitivity, root sensitivity, and just plain sensitivity.